What if I told you that AI was going to make us more human? My name is Ronnie Chatterji, and I'm a professor at the Fuqua School of Business at Duke University. In November of 2024, I became the first chief economist of OpenAI, the company behind the artificial intelligence revolution. AI is the mother of all opportunities and challenges. It's going to affect everything we do. If AI is done right, we can actually build stronger human connections. And it might allow us to actually take a step back from the screen and focus more on what's in front of us. I believe the pros outweigh the cons, of course. Otherwise, I wouldn't be doing the job. But at the same time, I can be really clear-eyed about how it's going to affect the world. One thing I was worried about was, wow, if I'm working at the organization, will I be able to explore all these negative dimensions or use cases that might not be as desirable? They've really allowed me to explore all these dimensions and be very upfront about some of the challenges that AI is facing. What's really interesting to me is, like, we're going to have jobs that we never imagined because of AI. At the same time, people in existing roles, like, think about a professor like me, I'm going to have to change and up my game because of AI. And if I don't get with the program on that, other people will use those tools in ways that allow them to go past me. For most folks, I think it's going to eventually complement what they do, allow them to be more productive. But for some, right, it will be able to do the job that they're doing. And then some jobs, right, might disappear completely. And that's really scary. And the anxiety there is really justifiable. And the question is, how do we prepare people for that? How do we train people for what's next? And how do we let people use AI to their advantage? I grew up in the age when the internet was becoming ubiquitous. And we used to talk about this thing called the digital divide. And it was this notion that a lot of people had access to the internet and were able to do amazing things, but not everybody did. And it created these huge inequities because the internet became important in everything we did, at work and how we related to each other. And I thought that with artificial intelligence, we were on the cusp of something that could be just as big, if not bigger, than the internet. What if we were going to make the same mistakes again? And so if we can democratize AI and at least make sure that it's in people's hands, so they can use it to solve problems in front of them, we have a better chance of making sure that the opportunity, the bounty from AI, is spread out more evenly. This is where research is going to be so important, because there's still so much that we do not know about how AI is going to affect the way we work and live. And if we look at it using a narrow computer science or engineering lens only, without thinking about the other parts of the equation, we're really missing a huge opportunity to shape what happens next. When you think about the infrastructure we're going to need to build to power AI, we'll need data centers with large amounts of computer chips in them connected to reliable energy. And that's going to have an impact on the grid. It's going to have an impact on sustainability. Researchers are going to play a big role in understanding how to make chips more efficient, how to make sure we recycle water and reduce water usage where we can, and how we create innovations to provide more clean energy to the grid so we're not making a negative environmental impact. And Duke is uniquely positioned with strong, incredibly strong departments, obviously in the core fields like computer science, but also in all the other places, in philosophy, in business, in law, in divinity, in the environmental sciences, right? Civil engineering, to put that together to have a multifaceted perspective on the problem. When policymakers, when business leaders have questions about the future of AI, they're not only going to be asking the technical questions, they're going to be asking questions about impact. A lot of the most important innovations of our time got their roots from university research, often funded by the government, things like the National Science Foundation and the National Institutes of Health. And so there's always been a really tight connection between sort of amazing universities like Duke and innovation and entrepreneurship in the real world. And when I look back 10 or 15 years from now, I'm hoping that AI will have produced a lot of jobs and a lot of opportunity, a lot of value. I also hope that AI is going to have solved a lot of challenges, cured diseases, made our relationships with one another more meaningful, not less. And the biggest failure I can make is not thinking big enough, not doing everything I can in this job to prepare the world for what's happening with AI. And if I don't do that, and I look back 10 or 15 years from now, I'm going to feel like I really failed. If we do well, I think we're going to be more prosperous and happy because of the AI revolution. And while I'm not going to be able to control every part of that, I think the economic piece and giving people an honest sense of where it's going is going to be an important contribution.